Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Motoroids. My name is Karan, and today we have the Royal Enfield Himalayan ABS with us. What's new about this motorcycle? Well, it's pretty much the same bike as it was. However, now it gets the addition of dual channel ABS. So what the Himalayan ABS gets is only an ABS system. In addition to that, there aren't any other changes on the motorcycle visually or mechanically. And it still remains that very capable motorcycle if you want to go off the road or if you want to travel long distances. This is a great choice. So how do you differentiate the normal Himalayan from the ABS Himalayan? So there's that sticker over there and that ABS ring over here, which will help you differentiate this ABS Himalayan from the normal Himalayan that does not get ABS. What will also tell you about the presence of ABS on this motorcycle is this light here in the instrument console. So how has the addition of ABS on the Himalayan affected the way it brakes? To tell you about the bike, we already have done a comprehensive review about it, the link for which you can find up above. And braking performance was lacking in the earlier gen Himalayan or the BS4 model that landed earlier this year. The feel at this lever, if we talk about the front disc brake in isolation, it still feels very wooden. There's a lack of bite and you don't really feel all that confidence for the kind of capabilities this motorcycle packs and the performance it offers. And having said that, even the rear brake, because now this is a motorcycle which is very, very capable off the road, with the addition of ABS, what happens is, if you are someone who wants to exploit what this motorcycle can do off the road, that rear section cannot be locked, and when you're turning into a corner or even when you want to slide the rear so that you can quickly change the direction of the motorcycle using that rear tire, that is something which cannot be done now. So what we would have liked if Royal Enfield would have added the option of switching ABS off altogether. However, that option does not exist. ABS always will stay on this bike. However, for someone who will be riding this motorcycle in a sedate manner off the road, on the road, that added safety net of ABS will make them confidence all the more. But then, for someone who wants to exploit what this motorcycle has to offer, ABS should have been switchable. Now we'll talk about braking performance in three different situations. First is on the road, on the tarmac. The amount of confidence one must have in a motorcycle, especially during panic braking situations, that is still something where the Himalayan doesn't score as high. So for all the capabilities that it has as a motorcycle, what it can do, those brakes definitely need to get a little more better than what they are right now. It's not that it doesn't stop, but you really need that confidence for what this bike can do. Instance number two, if you're riding off the road, if the motorcycle is going through a patch where there's grass or loose gravel, when you're riding through that kind of stuff and you stand on the rear brake, the ABS unit keeps cutting in frequently. And even if you're trying to use your left or right foot as an anchor for the bike to slide around and stop, that is not the case because the bike will stay straight, which is again great for someone who wouldn't be pushing this motorcycle as much. Also, what happens is when you're going off the road, your natural instinct is not to touch that front brake, but then because you know that ABS keeps cutting in, you have to use that front brake as well off the road, which is not something you would do naturally if you know how to ride a motorcycle off the road. Now the third instance is during wet conditions, which is when ABS is a great system to have, be it any kind of rider, novice, rookie, expert. So with those three instances, we think the addition of ABS is great on the Himalayan, especially in terms of equipment. Having said that, what we would like to see and what we would like to suggest Royal Enfield is that the Interceptor and the Continental GT 650, those two bikes are the ones which have really sorted out braking problems for Royal Enfield, and how we wish this motorcycle to gets that level of kit which will complete the entire picture and tick that only missing link for the Royal Enfield Himalayan. Otherwise, we have ridden this motorcycle extensively in the Himalayas for about 1500 kilometers, and we know what it can do off the road, on the road, and even when you're traveling long distances, it still is a very comfortable motorcycle if you have to cover all those miles, even in the city. If you live somewhere where the roads are broken and there's more of that rough stuff rather than paved surfaces, this is a great machine to be riding in the city too. And what we have also noticed with this latest Himalayan, now this is a brand new bike, it has only done about 180 kilometers on the odometer. We've noticed fit and finish has definitely improved. So on that note, the Himalayan still remains a very unique motorcycle wherein you don't really have another choice if you want something which is capable off the road and on the road. This is the only option you have, unless you're ready to spend more for the BMW GS310, which again is not really as capable of the road, and this is still a wonderful machine if you're someone who is an adventurer at heart. And on that note, if you did like this video, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and do hit that share button to share this video with your friends. My name is Karan, this is Motoroids. Until next time, we'll see you again. Goodbye.